Man, Brad Marchand really screwed up your day, didn't he?
He didn't even wait till the spring this time.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the?
Not nice! There's a giant head!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
You know what? The Leafs lost and I'm giving them a treat anyway, because I had a tough day!
Okay, what do you want to talk about? Leafs lose 5-2 at the hands of the Boston Bruins, and I can't help but feel like you all want me to talk about something else!
Alright! Give me a sec.
Oh, this puffer really works.
Real quick, think you know which way it's gonna go? Like when you send a tweet, you're like, everyone's gonna love this. Well, make your bet at Sports Interaction.
When the puck drops, Sports Interaction has you covered pregame, live betting on all major sports, and prop bets. Want to bet? Visit sportsinteraction.com/STPN. That's sportsinteraction.com/STPN or download the app, but it's 19 plus. Please play responsibly.
All right, okay, let's talk about it. There was a Leafs-Bruins thing that made the rounds today and people were very excited about it. I think it got out of hand, but it's ridiculous. Here, you know what? I'm not even ashamed of it. I just want to show you. The Money Puck deserved a win-o-meter had the Leafs winning that game 70.4% of the time. What game were you watching? What?
Also, there was a thing with me and Brad Marchand that I talked about on the podcast, but I'll talk about it here now that, it's not happening as I'm recording. So outside of everyone just saying LMAO owned, there were also a lot of people going, I have no idea what's going on. The story is so ridiculous. Starting it from the beginning makes it even dumber, but we kinda have to, so I'm gonna do it.
Okay, few days ago, the Anaheim Ducks play the Arizona Coyotes. Steve Marchand doesn't play for either of those teams, and neither of those teams are the Leafs. I know. But there was a game between the Ducks and the Coyotes, and Zegras, who's on the Ducks, said something to Troy Stetcher, who is on the Coyotes. It made Troy Stetcher extremely mad. Rumors were flying here, there, and everywhere about what Trevor Zegras said, and a bunch of people turned into lip readers, and clips were going all around. But at the end of the day, the Ducks didn't say anything, the Coyotes didn't say anything, so we didn't know what he said. Then, doing a little bit of that journalism, Craig Morgan, who covers the Coyotes for The Athletic, tweeted this. I can confirm via the Coyotes that Anaheim forward Trevor Zegras did not say anything about Troy Stetcher's father during their dust-up last night, but per a team source, he crossed the line with some very inappropriate comments. Stetcher has declined to comment on the topic.
Right, I left that part out. The accusation was Zegras said something about Stetcher's father, and Stetcher was very upset about that, but that isn't what happened, according to Craig Morgan's sources with the Coyotes.
Then this tweet comes out of nowhere from Brad Marchand. Shut your pie hole, Craig! So, knowing the context, that's weird. Like, what? Shut your pie? Why? Why? How come? For what purpose? This has 5,800 likes! Why do 5,800 people agree with this? He's just doing his job! You all asked the question!
For days, all Hockey Twitter talked about was what did Trevor Zegras say to Troy Stetcher, and this guy who covers the Coyotes decided to ask, and then he tweeted out his answer, and then Brad Marchand, who plays for the very not Ducks or Coyotes, said shut your pie hole. And that's okay, like he's allowed. I'd like to know why he said it. Like it's not even like he has to apologize for it. I don't think he should apologize for it. That's a very strange thing to say. Do you know something, Brad? Do you know what was said? I can only guess because all you gave us was shut your pie hole.
Which brings us to today. The Boston Bruins are visiting Toronto for the second time this season, and people were looking to get their fun questions in on account of last time the Boston Bruins came to town. It was under the cloud of the Mitchell Miller signing that they made for no good reason, and it was a distraction. They lost that game back when they weren't losing any games. So naturally, someone asked about it. It's a reporter named Jacob Stoller. Quote, I asked Brad Marchand about this tweet after the morning skate at Scotiabank Arena today. What inclined him to tweet that? Ah, nothing, said Marchand. I read that tweet and that's what popped in my head, so I said it. Weird. Before we continue, I know Jacob injected weird
into that. I just want to remind you that the thing he was saying weird to is there was an incident in a Ducks-Coyotes game, and a reporter tweeted about the incident, and Brad Marchand, who's on the Bruins, told the reporter to shut their pie hole. That is quite indeed weird. But Brad didn't like it. He responded, "I'm sorry you didn't like my answer, Jacob. Would you like me to say something different so you don't have something so stupid to hang your career on? Great reporting this morning." Again, that has 3,300 likes. What? Would you like me to say something different? Yeah. You said, oh, I just tweeted whatever popped in my head. What if there was like a Carolina Hurricanes versus St. Louis Blues game? And some Blues reporter was just like, Ryan O'Reilly thinks the Blues need to work on their power play. And I responded, ah, shut up, you jabroni. You might laugh, but also, Steve, why'd you say that? That's weird. But beyond that, it's Brad Marchand punching down, and I didn't like it. I saw a lot of people, oh, reporters, oh, the Toronto media. What are you talking about? Jacob has 3,000 followers. I met him during the Marlies Calder Cup run in 2018. He's young, he's starting his career. I'm not gonna lie, I hadn't spoken to Jacob in a few years. I thought he was in Winnipeg, because if I'm not mistaken, Jacob, that's where you're from. So he works for the Hockey News now, and he gets this opportunity, which I think is really cool, and he has the stones to ask Marchand a question, which early on in my career, I was just standing in scrums holding a mic. I wasn't asking questions. And when I did, they were bad. So he asked him a question, he relayed the answer, he did interject weird, but I think we're leaving out the part where he's right! He's correct! That is a very weird response, Brad. And then he proceeded to punch down because he's embarrassed and frankly, I think, just not telling us something, which is fine. So I tweeted, "That make you feel big? The fuck is this? Relax." To which Marchand replies, "Was that your mighty roar?" Actually, you know what's funny? That's not what he said. "Was that your mighty might roar?" It's 11 o'clock and I just noticed that part of the tweet for the first time. And that meant I was owned. Man, I just owned. He found a picture of me that I took at a photo shoot that I paid for. Oh no, I hope that doesn't get out there. He took I literally had a cardboard cutout of that at my book launch. And it just says, "Was that your mighty might roar?" 11,000 likes and like 1,000 quote tweets. Just shredding my entire life. Not the first time Brad Marchand has thrown a punch and had a bunch of teammates swarm in after. So I said, "Absolutely, LOL. Thought you of all people would appreciate someone being the third man in." Get it? Because he's often the third man in scrums. It's not my best work. Whatever. But people are like, "You had 40 minutes to come up with that!" I was literally recording the podcast. You can see it live. I see it and I go, and I laugh and I write a response and I put my phone down. And we continue to record the rest of the show. So anyway, this doesn't change my thoughts on Brad Marchand. I've been pretty open about it. I don't like him on the ice, which is the biggest compliment in the world that I could pay to him. If I wore this and said, I think Brad Marchand is just great, do you think he'd like that? I don't. He wants me to hate him. He wants Leaf fans to hate him. He wants everyone who is not a Bruins fan do not like him. It's his thing. It means he's doing his job. I don't like him on the ice. Off the ice, Brad Marchand seems like a great guy. Genuinely. He's generous with his time. He seems to be a good leader in the Bruins locker room. He seems great with the fans. I just didn't like this one thing where I thought he was punching down. He was punching down. None of this I thought. He was punching down. I didn't like it, so I injected myself. And I'm getting flamed for it with the same 5 chirps and emojis and GIFs over and over again, and that's fine. I can handle it. I have over 200,000 Twitter followers, so does Brad. Pick on someone your own size. Here I am. And he had at me. There you go. I think that's the way it should go, don't you? Whatever, dude. As for the game, it went better than I thought, honestly. First half was really good. The Leafs were keeping up with the Bruins. The Bruins were getting a lot of the early chances, but the Leafs came back and they got a few of their own and they stayed with them. There was never a moment in the first half after the few minutes where it felt like the Leafs were just
playing for survival. Then they allow the shorthanded goal, and things get a little wobbly. Like, even after the Leafs tie it up at 1-1, it just felt like the game was a little too run-and-gun, like a lack of structure. And if they continued to play this way, they were eventually going to get burnt. They did! I saw a lot of people talking about Simmons and get Simmons off the team. Dude, you're talking about their 12th forward tonight. You're talking about like their 13th, 14th forward on most nights. Replacing Wayne Simmons with a different player in the lineup wasn't going to give them the win in this one. Sheldon Keefe went to Liljegren and Sandin more than he usually does, or in different situations than he usually does. And they got lit up. It wasn't good. Samsonov, after a few brilliant saves in the first period, oh boy, he didn't have a great time, did he? He wasn't able to perform miracles, which is unfortunate because the team in front of him was forcing him to try to perform miracles. I got a few more things I want to say about the game, but I'll be able to answer them within your questions. How does it feel losing to Marchand twice in one day? I'd like to report a murder. Dude, I've been a YouTuber since 2007. I've been taking abuse on the internet for 16 seasons of this, so maybe it's just not registering anymore. I get better chirps from Adam and Jesse when they're telling me hello and goodbye. I have unresolved trauma older than you. You think I'm afraid of you? What's your best headache cure? Putting down your phone. I'm kidding, just water and Advil. What do you think is in Brad Marchand's camera roll on his phone? You wanna see what's in Brad Marchand's camera roll? There, this photo of me is in Brad Marchand's camera roll. Oh, Steve, the Bruins live rent-free. Yeah? Yeah? I'm in your favorite player's phone. We are not the same. I don't believe this one for one second. I'm a Bruins fan, and I'm genuinely worried that the Leafs are going to beat the Bruins if they meet in the playoffs this year. Would beating the Bruins at their record-breaking pace make up for all the losses to the Bruins over the years? First of all, I don't believe you for a second. You're a Bruins fan, you just watched that game, and you're worried? What? You should just become a Leafs fan, if that's the case. Like, if you want to be worried and have an actual reason to be worried, just come cheer for us. Will it make up for it? No, absolutely not. Will I care that it doesn't make up for it? No. Dude, does anyone remember how the Bruins were eliminated from the 2010 Stanley Cup playoffs? You might not. If you're a Bruins fan, you know. But if you're not a Bruins fan, you probably don't remember. You remember that they won the Cup in 2011, and that's all that matters. But what if I told you that in 2010, they had a 3-0 series lead on the Philadelphia Flyers? The Flyers come back to force Game 7. The Flyers are down 3-0 to the Bruins in that Game 7, and the Bruins blew that! And the Flyers won and moved on and went to the Stanley Cup Final. But they didn't win. And then the next year, the Bruins played them again, swept them, and won the Cup. It was the only series they played that year where it didn't go 7 games. I believe there's a saying, he who laughs last laughs best, or he who laughs most recently, I suppose. If the Leafs win in 2023, you're gonna get lots of chirps about 13 and 18 and 19, and I can't believe it's not more, actually. But all that matters is this year, baby. But you're still talking in hypotheticals. I'll ask a question. When can we ask the refs some? My answer is two-pronged. Number one, you're never gonna be able to ask the refs anything. It's a genuinely terrible league for a genuinely fantastic sport. The National Hockey League is such a shame that it's the biggest league for what I believe to be the greatest sport. I love hockey so much. The NHL is so bad. Now, that being said, cry about it. Like, cry about it. It is what it is. Bunting should have drawn a call, I think. Now, everyone has their reasons for why Bunting didn't draw a call. He complains about everything. And the refs don't like him. They don't like him. Let's call it what it is. They don't call games in a biased and impartial way. They don't like him. And what are you going to do about it? Who do you complain to? Change is the slowest thing in the world to the National Hockey League. What are you going to do? You're going to complain to the guy who's been in charge for 30 years? Oh, yeah. What a beacon of change. Gary Bettman, 30 years at the helm. Yeah, let's complain to him. Or let's complain to Bill Daly, who is the Robin to his Batman. Or let's complain to George Parros. Or let's complain to... I got an idea. How about this? You don't yell and scream at the guys
whose job it is to call the game every shift. Yeah, but nothing. Well, that's not fair. What? What does that have to do with anything? Fair? Fair? You're in the wrong business. You want fair? Mm-mm. Don't play in the NHL. Don't play in any sport that has a referee. Fair? Even if they're the best person on earth, they're gonna make mistakes. And that's best case scenario. If they're a great guy and they call it right down the middle, they're gonna miss stuff. And then you add on to that all their very human flaws. So what are you doing yelling and screaming and waving your blood at them? That's supposed to help? What does it accomplish? It's a fun gif. Does it help your team win? No, it doesn't. Doesn't it suck watching all four lines finish their checks for the Bruins and we only have one guy who does it who isn't even regularly in the lineup? You know what's funny? I was about to say, hey, Wayne Simmonds isn't the only guy who does that. They have Dryden Hunt too, but he's on the Marlies. Listen, the number one compliment I can pay to the Boston Bruins, it's they know their brand. They play Boston Bruins hockey. And that is part of the reason why I think they're doing so well in what is probably Patrice Bergeron's final year. They have had a brand the entire time that dude has been there. I think it was established by Zdeno Chara, but it's stuck around with this leadership group. They work harder than you. They hit harder than you. They make your night less enjoyable than theirs. That's their brand. And look at lines 1 through 4. Like, they got some big guys. Yeah, they got some tough customers. But the rest of the guys who aren't conventionally large or tough or whatever, they hit. My camera cut me off in the middle of my rant. They hit! They work hard and they dig. All these things that, frankly, I think the Leafs are getting better at, they're just not there. There's another echelon. How could you say that the Leafs are top five? How many times do I gotta say they gotta play Tampa in the first round? Is what it is, man. Oh, this playoff format. This playoff format, what? It's February. That ship is, you can't even see it over the horizon. Figure it out. And we'll end with this. Riley is terrible, .. That's not a question, but I'll do my best to answer it anyway. Listen, the Leafs top six, Liljegren, Sandin, they didn't have their best night. I think they're generally better than that. I'm not too worried about them. Giordano Hall, that's your third pair. Probably plays too much. But they're most nights not bad. They have a few stinker nights. Riley Brody hasn't gotten to play together too much. And when they have, it hasn't been great. So this thing about the Leafs need to go out and get a forward. I do think they need a forward. We see how much was taken out of their lineup when they lose Austin Matthews. And yes, it's a superstar, but you go from Matthews Tavares to Tavares Kerfoot. It's a huge drop off, right? So a forward would be good. Someone who can play left wing, I think would be really good. Push Bunting down, maybe. I think that'd be good. But if you can upgrade your D, I think you have to. And you're probably wondering how they do it. I think it would involve pitching someone on the current D core out the door. The only guy it really makes sense for is Justin Hall. Like, just in terms of money, and you could make a significant upgrade on your right side. And then all of a sudden, if you have a stronger right side, you have the option of using Brody on the left if you want to. I just feel like it makes your defense that much more versatile. And they weren't able to handle Boston tonight. It's a litmus test game. So I talked about what the Leafs can bring into the team, but ultimately, Riley's got to take this break. The whole team's got to take this break. They got to heal up, go to their happy place, do whatever they got to do, and come back, because there's no turning back after the All-Star break. It's just a few more games. There's the trade deadline, and then whoever's there is there. Look to the guy to your left. Look to the guy to your right. If you're going to win, it's going to be with them. That is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. That's my mighty might roar.
Mighty Might Roar.